I want to talk a little bit about the documentary. Mm-hmm. Because again, I read that, first of all, tell me about Stanley Nelson. Why was he the guy to do it?
He was the guy who, I mean, we had several, or I mean, at least a couple of meetings with him before we actually did it. And mm-hmm. and some of them were 10 years before the meetings where we decided to do it. Like, he came in and he was, you know, we saw some of his films and, you know, he seemed really cool, but I don't know, it just felt right in the room. Like, you know, when you talk to him, and he's kind of like a no-nonsense. He doesn't try to, there's no, like, glad handing. There's no, like, let's talk about something else before we talk about this. It was like, just, let's just, he's like, I'm ready to do it.
Is it true that you didn't see the film until?
Like a night or two before it premiered at Sundance. And, you know, that was our agreement, you know. Like, we're not filmmakers. We're, you know, we like making films about Miles, but I don't. Mm-hmm. I'm not a director. I don't edit. I don't. You know. So once you turn it over to them, it becomes their project. And then, you know, we were lucky enough to, you know, he was gracious enough to let us see it before everybody else.
He sent us a link. Yeah. A couple of nights before.
What'd you think when you saw it?
I called him. And I was crying. It was like 3 a.m. and he hung up. He said, "I'm asleep. I'll call you tomorrow." You know. But I was, like Erin said, we didn't know what it was going to be. You know, we didn't know. We didn't know anything.
Yeah.
Thank God that we hooked up with him to make that documentary, man. Yeah,
it's a beautiful film.
Yeah.
Just a beautiful film. So, last question. I read a quote of yours, Erin, where you said, it's taken you 20 years to realize what we're doing and how it affects the future. Hmm. And I'm wondering what you've learned in that time.
I learned a lot. I mean, I gotta say that without Vince, this would have been shambles. Like, this would have been a hard job for just me and Cheryl to do, or what? Yeah. I mean, his mom, you know, Dorothy was there, and after Miles died, and Vernon, our uncle, was there. So it was like good to have. You know, their guidance in those early years, because I was like, I had no idea. I was still playing in bands, and I was still like, I don't know what we're doing. Like, well, is the box set great? You know, later on, you know, we ran into some issues, and we, to get through them, we had to make a lot of changes in our team, I guess. And once those changes happened, it was hard to do at first, especially for me, because these people had been with us forever. Some of them had been with Miles, even. But then things started. I started to see things. I'm like, oh, I see how this business works. How the catalog business works. How having a legacy, having an artist who isn't around to promote new releases or collaborations or licensing deals or anything, you know. And once I started to learn really how to work this, you know, like I said, though, it couldn't be without Vince, without, you know, Cheryl. We hired Daryl Porter from, you know, to be our general manager. And, you know, these things were important to do, you know, because, you know, if you don't own the masters of something, you have to work with the label, you know what I mean? And that's fine. We've had great relationships. We have a great relationship with Kraft. We have a good relationship with Sony, with Rhino, and with Universal. But, you know, it's not always been easy, you know, and those 20, it's been 20 years. Mm-hmm. It's been a long time. It's been longer, I think, but, you know, I wasn't sure what we were supposed to be doing in the beginning, and now it seems more apparent than ever. Mm.